Pete, could you tell me a little bit about metrics and how you guys went about measuring things in the early days and what was important to measure?
That's a really good question because you're pretty resource constrained early on, and every moment you spend implementing some fancy analytic is one less moment you could be focusing on your customers or your product. But when I look back, I think there were a few things that we tracked that were really helpful. The first, and they're not all numbers, in fact. The first was Dan, my co-founder, set up an email that would email everyone in the company every single day and say, here's the list of everybody who signed up for our product today. And I remember being so excited when, you know, I noticed somebody from Starbucks had signed up, or, you know, we'd noticed this big company or this big company. And that gave us a pretty simple way to jump on these moments, you know, email and say, hey, what's going on? Can we help you? And I think some of our longest lasting customer relationships started through that. So it was a really easy way to plug into what was actually happening with our customers. The second one is it sounds a little funny, actually. We made it impossible to fire Optimizely without sending us an email. So we didn't build any way to unsubscribe from our service. Instead, we said, if you want to unsubscribe, email Optimizely. And we were a little worried that people would be really pissed off about this, and one or two were. But it also gave us a really, really clear and quick way to understand where we were screwing up. And, you know, I think where otherwise some of these customers would have sort of silently drifted into the night, this gave us an avenue to ask what was going wrong, what could we have done to have kept you as a happy customer. And we didn't earn them all back. We probably didn't earn many of them back, to be honest, at first. But it was a pretty easy way to find out where we're screwing up. And so I'd like to think that the most important metrics early on were the ones that help us stay attuned to where we were pleasing and where we were angering our customers.
So given where the company is currently, what do you think is important to measure in the next couple months or years?
Well, we're a lot bigger now. We're hundreds of employees, and we have thousands of customers. And we've gotten a lot more sophisticated in how we measure our financials as a company, so how we forecast GAAP revenue analysis and all of that. And that's been very illuminating. It's great as a founder to be able to have that view into your business. One of the things that we're trying to build out now, I mentioned this before, is the ability to measure customers in the same way and to give everybody inside Optimizely this same crystal clear view of how our customers are doing and how good the experience we're giving them is. And the way we do that is with the Optimizely promoter system. I mentioned this before. It's a variant of NPS, Net Promoter System. And we ask our customers a simple question, and we ask them to explain how likely would they be to recommend Optimizely to a friend or a colleague. And based on that answer and based on the reason they give for their answer, we get insights into how well we're doing. And it's pretty easy to spot leading indicators, which we expect will later show up in the revenue elsewhere. You know, if we're giving our customers a bad experience, we'd expect to see that in churn numbers. Mm. But churn is a trailing indicator. We're doing our best now to build leading indicators of how well we're treating our customers. And that's a big challenge for us over the next few years.
Yeah, sounds like it.